Hi, welcome back to The Shtick. I'm in the studio with Iain Hewitson. Hi, Iain.
G'day, mate.
We were just talking in the last segment about this book, and we only touched the surface because I think we should go into a little bit more detail. This show is actually a dedication to Mirka Mora, the late, great Mirka Mora. And she started this restaurant with her husband, Georges, in the 60s sometime. Yes. No one knows exactly when, because it was that time when nobody knew what was going on. You know, it was just like the revolution. The revolution. And they had a gallery there. They had a restaurant there and a hotel. Was there a hotel there as well?
I don't know whether it was operating as a hotel. I think there were too many destitute artists living in there. So, you know, it was a bit like that.
Yeah, well, we didn't really mention that Georges and Mirka actually started the scene. The scene in Melbourne, because Melbourne was a dead Victorian city.
As they were so straight.
Daniel Andrews, in his speech at the memorial, said that Melbourne was Victorian rather than Victoria. Yeah. And it's so true. And in the 50s, when Mirka and Georges arrived, they had a cafe, restaurant in Collins Street.
Yeah, and then they went on to Balzac.
Which was in East Melbourne. Yeah, in East Melbourne.
Yeah, and Mirka was allowed to paint a couple of little walls there, but not
Balzac.
She didn't get free rein like she did at Tolarno.
It was such a legendary place, the Balzac.
Yes, well, that's right. But I think the thing about Tolarno was because she had done this wonderful artwork, the cherubs smiled. They really did. When you walked in the room, it was a happy room.
It was lit up.
Yes, it was a happy room.
Yes.
Yeah, sure it was a bit shabby. Sure it was a bit bohemian. The toilets weren't too flash, and we won't get into that, but it just had a feel to it. And Leon Massoni ran it for a number of years after Georges and Mirka parted company and sort of went their own ways. And he was a lot straighter, wonderful restaurateur, you know, but he'd come
from... His origin was from Florentina.
Yes, well, that's what I was just going to say, And he was a lot straighter. I mean, he was a wonderful restaurateur, but he was a lot straighter. When we went in there after Leon...
What year was that, in 1994 or something?
Something like that, yeah, it would have been around that. We went in and we wanted to put that sense of fun back in, and I was with Ruth Allen, my business partner, and her brother Barney Allen. And we had a lot of fun there.
Yeah.
And
the side bar. I used to go into the side bar more than the restaurant. And that was always a place to find people. And it was so cool.
It was cool in a funny way because it was shabby and, as I said, bohemian. And we did live music there and we had fun. But I reckon that if somebody had flicked, you know, the chocolate mousse over the room, I don't think we would have worried.
No.
I think Leon would have, but I don't think we would have. Because it was fun.
And then you were there for 15-odd years.
Yes, that's right.
And you ran a very successful business.
Yeah, we had a disagreement with the new landlords.
Right, and then they doubled the rent and you...
Just little things like
you
that.
You balked, of course, at that. And
balked. Balked, that's a good word. I don't think it was quite balked. I think I swore at them in about 19 different languages.
And walked out.
And walked out.
And Guy Grossi then eventually took it over.
Yeah, it's never worked since. I think, and this is don't take me the wrong way, Guy Grossi, great restaurateur, and you know, I don't know the people that went after him. But the point about it was it lost its sense of fun.
Mm.
And once it lost its sense of fun, they even repainted the murals and things like that. And once they did that, it lost that lovely feel. The cherub stopped smiling.
There was a chap who was going to buy the restaurant and he told you about it and said, oh, we're going to paint it all, we're going to cover up all those murals.
All those murals. I mean, this is when I bought
Can
it.
You imagine?
This was when I was at Memories of the Mediterranean. This guy comes and he says, oh, I'm buying Tolarno. I said, oh, one of my favourite restaurants of all time. And I mean this very sincerely. It really was one of my favourites. And he said, oh, I'm going to get rid of all those murals. I'm going to paint them. Oh, my God. I said, what is wrong with you? Anyway, I rang the agent and he said, oh, the deal hasn't been done. You can make an offer. So I made an offer and we bought it.
Fantastic.
But he wasn't the only one. I remember these new owners who I had the moments with. When they first walked in, they said to Ruth and I, they said, oh, well, you should get rid of all this stuff on the wall. You could paint this. They later, in later times, became the champions of Mirka, but they had no idea who she was
when
they first
came.
And it was the reason we bought it, and it was the reason we pushed Mirka the whole time we're there. Anyone that ever asked us, why have you bought Tolarno? We said, because somebody has to preserve Mirka's work. Because it was just a wonderful space. It was an ugly little room, but it was a wonderful space because of her beautiful paintings. And can I tell one story? And I know I shouldn't. You're going to say to me,
we might
keep it short.
Cut this out, but anyway.
Keep it short. Mirka did a tour of some people once, you know, and they were very posh, you know, upmarket from Brighton and Toorak and places like that. And one of the ladies said to her, why did you paint so many geese? And Mirka, being her usual mischievous self, she said, and I'll keep myself decent, she said, because the necks remind me of penises.
Dickies. Penis. She used to call them dickies.
Dear. Well, actually, she didn't use either of those words, but we'll keep ourselves decent. And like, I had to leave.
Like roosters, you know,
yes,
cocks.
Yes, that's right. Yeah. I had to leave the room because I was laughing so much. And you should have seen the look on this woman's face. She was just mortified. No one's ever mentioned that word to me before, you know. It was very funny. But that was what Mirka was like. She loved to shock. Mm. It was her fun. And she was a beautiful woman inside and out. And I loved preserving her heritage at that restaurant for 15 years.
Yeah, well, I did an interview with her over 10 years ago in her studio.
Yep.
I went in there amongst all that amazing... Yeah.
Took you 3 hours to get in.
The mess. Yeah. It was, she said, oh, well, God bless my mess, she said. And I've been using
yes,
that
I
myself.
Remember the room.
Yeah,
yes.
You remember the room. It was a studio and a kitchen and a bedroom
if
and all.
If you could see the kitchen.
And it was such a great pleasure to speak to her. She'd never heard of the shtick. Because at that time, you know, she wasn't really watching TV. She was too busy. She was still painting,
yes.
Very active. She was an amazing producer of, I mean, when you look at how prolific she was over
the
years.
And the dolls. Oh, and those wonderful dolls.
Not to mention the dolls.
Yeah.
I know. Well,
sorry
I was at the.
Story.
No, it's okay. I was at the memorial, and just to get off the interview, because that was another experience. I mean, it was one of the best interviews I've done, and I've done 1,000 at least on the show. But at the memorial, I was told I wasn't allowed to film because I hadn't applied to the Premier's department there, you know, communications.
As you should.
Shtick. But in keeping with Mirka's maverick style, because she was always anti-establishment, always.
You ignored the rules.
She was a strong, hardcore feminist and a strong, hardcore...
Yes.
She was a rebel.
Yes.
I can't think of a better word because she did things that nobody else even would consider.
Yeah.
In her style, that she'd take her dress off. Somebody said, oh, I like your dress. You should take a dress off and give it to me. Right, you know, like that. That sort of thing that Mirka did. So we're going to go into the next segment with unauthorised footage of the event. So just be little clips.
Oh, that's completely in line with what Mirka would have wanted you to do,
exactly.
Isn't it?
So this is dedicated.
If you don't like it, Premier's department, tough.
It's been so nice to have you on
the
show.
Yes,
thank you. Iain Hewitson, better known as Huey. So check out his YouTube, what's it called, Fabulous...
Huey's Fabulous Fast Food for one or two.
Or two. We'll be back after the break with without me... We'll have some excerpts from the memorial service.
Authorised, of course.
Uncut. Cut.